awesome, energetic tonight. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Much better. Hi, my name is Chantal Samuels, and I'm the Chief Executive Officer of the Coastal Zone Management Authority and Institute. And on behalf of that organization, I would like to welcome you to Tides of Men. Tonight, you will be introduced to our first of its kind stage play, whereby we will be combining comedy and drama and excitement to convey some very key messages affecting the coastal zone of Belize. We are challenged with being able to balance the needs of sustainable development in the country with conservation goals. And so this play will help to convey this message to you in a way that it will be fun and educational. I'm not sure if you all realize, but CZMAI is in its 20th year of existence. It was established on April 16th, 1998. And so since April of this year, we've been hosting a series of educational and awareness events to commemorate this important milestone. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the staff of CZMAI who worked tirelessly to help to put this production together. I must especially single out Mr. Gilbert Andrews. He's our environmental lab technician, and he was the one who had the idea, and he came to me and I said, you know what, that's a really great idea, and I know the perfect person that could help to bring this play to life, the very talented Mr. Joseph Stampromero and his cast, of course. So I was here last night for the dress rehearsal, and you're in for quite a show tonight. So with that said, I would like to close my opening remarks and thank you once again for coming tonight, and I do hope that you will enjoy the show. Thank you.
Just to sync up this place, I allow adults to have such
alone. Left me alone. Left me alone. Left me alone. Stop it. Stop it. Left me alone. Left me alone.
Fisher,
Everybody in this whole village know that anybody who work here know plenty times more than you. So don't make nobody hear you with that.
What is people are talking about?
They say what? That you like run your mouth?
Well, forget around, right? But people concerned that when you dig up the beach and put down your building, that this has something that will benefit you. I mean, you cut down most of my growth and the bone fish that goes scarce. We eat for this beach alone.
Sonny, bone fish not scarce because of me. Bone fish scarce because of you, my brother.
Me?
That you would bring in all the tourists here to come to sports fishing. I don't know, follow no rules, no regulations, no nothing. And when it comes to the mangrove, I only cut down the mangrove in front of my piece of property. As a matter of fact, it not even matter. Because we all fail to understand that sacrifice comes with progress. That the others has a sacrifice you have to make. Right, Fisher?
No, I must lie to you, no?
What, Fisher?
That's me, mangrove. Sonny, I don't shut up our man in one business. But sell a magic cheese and I'll scam somebody else.
No, about this. I just really have a message up here. I mean, look by the beach. Maybe in 30 that's here for you, nothing but garbage. How far is it have to go? And after I tell her to, the lady from the coastal zone office, because I saw how she wants to assist me in a building, but I'm not sure about that. I don't know how this will work.
Assistance? You don't need no assistance from nobody. I know what I do. Sonny, you know what are the real problem around this place? Everybody just jealous. They just cause me, Otis, to expand Mangrove Bay. And you know why they can't do it like the way I do it? Because they lack imagination. Right, Fisher?
So I don't like dead to let the teeth like you.
What, Fisher?
That's what they say. We lack imagination, we lack vision. They're like something black to win view. Like a black girl of Mangrove, Ariston in man.
Shut up, Fisher! Everybody know what imagination means. Man, you hurt your head. As a matter of fact, get back to work, you know. If you're not finished put up that roof there by the end of this evening, you could consider yourself jobless.
What is? You know something? You make me know what you want to know. But I come to the conclusion that you are because you can look for a job. So you could say that you will save my girl. But right now, I need a little more persuasion that works.
No touching her feeling while animals as it can add to the natural habitat. Do you want to know that?
Fisher, for the last time, get back to work! Understand this. You can't build tomorrow if you are worried about today. This is not a sacrifice that we have to make, okay?
Whatever, I think we got to clean the beach today.
Clean the beach? If you work for Sonny, you can clean the beach. As to me, me only the pay for what bring progress.
I can't be a me.
Not that damn itch. That mosquito can't get a piece of my life. Besides, he up to no good. He has a money hungry sea snake. And this is my family house. My grandfather left the legacy for me. For my family. And not that itch.
Albert, business fluffy yards. And plus nobody need a coin no more. And plus we need have more picnic to give it to.
Child or no child? This that not be what this. So need me and Sonny been talking here. Things are pick up soon. We just have to wait. Locals and tourists to come.
Sonny, the same was Sonny where can't even get what typical and he can't explain himself to nobody. Whereas even tourists and locals. That boy
a
waste of time, Albert.
Tell mom, what do you say? We are supposed to give up for we house to Otis. You know he's going to make an offer soon, right? And all he wants to bulldoze the place. He not even respect history, culture, and worse nature. What kind of plans he have for we beachfront over the summer?
That not even for we business or your business? Why you got that about you?
None of we business?
No.
None of we business. Tell mom, so what do you say? Only Otis have say enough, Mangrove here, just because he come across a little money. Tell me, you sound just like Fisher right now. You don't even
who?
Hear my ideas yet.
Who I sound like?
Fisher!
You're gone too far. How in the world you come to your wife to Fisher, of all persons? In fact, you know what? I think you, if you saw love this place, you are sleeping on the beach tonight with all your clothes. And I care that you are this fish, I always got nonsense.
Tell me, just this you put me on.
I don't want to handle
you. You just put me on the beach.
Yes, sir. Right?
Tough lady, here to be you, Ali.
Tell me, how many times have I told you, stop, call me Ali.
You're a child, right?
Don't throw me off already. And I'm an adult.
If that's the only reason you have, then I have to say, it's some kind of silly. You adults act like children all the time. Always fussing and complaining. Just like legally in my class.
And who you think we talk to? Oh, wait. We did a Sonny shop anyway. He hire you?
Sonny? Hire me? Sonny can't pronounce the word hire. He got, and I'm a thirsty, so I got a nice shop to drink this coconut water. Besides, he don't sell this anytime soon.
What? You know that is illegal, right?
What? Drinking bitter coconut water?
No, child, breaking and entering.
Well, it also should be illegal for a grown man forced to sleep on the beach. But I don't see the police looking into that and arresting Thelma.
This is gorgeous to you.
And no, to you. I did not marry her. That lady is a pain. But why you all think what is chasing you away? Aren't you adult enough to stand up for yourselves?
This is none of your business. And besides, I am my own boss. Otis can't chase me.
Same thing my daddy say. But when Otis call he willing to walk two tail. Pick me no dumb, you know, Ali. We no dumb none at all. You'd be surprised how much of your business I already here. Right past on the window. Your wife like that, you know, Ali. I would not tell she if I kill anybody. But let's. You're tired of your move, babe. I watch I want new view.
Anyways, Candy, this is not your concern. And a child should learn their place in adult's business.
And adults should decide where they sleep. But such is life. They can't sleep. Good old boy.
Candy, pick me up, Candy.
Can't it be just for you, baby? Yeah.
Not this Rosa, but you know what? You could go right ahead. I guess you forget I used to up here, you forget?
There ain't nobody here, I said to let me know, Rosa. No one wanna touch me. I was calling if you have got any problem with that lady.
That's funny, brother, because every time I get to your house, put up on the floor. You, Fisher, I would have beat up here to give you a blue eye, Miss Glenda.
Don't mess with abuse, Fisher. Abuse and dumb.
You sure it's worth it, man? You sure it's worth
earning
money
with
what this did
to
you? You must go
to bed,
me,
brother. What's the rule, sir? You can earn money and start saving for problems. What dirty water? Are you so peppy, man?
Peppy, Fisher. Me, peppy. Peppy that the dirty water when you see here, Fisher. But since you're so damn fool, let me spell it out for you. We, as in me, and you, and everybody else who live here, live by the coast, stupid. We have wildlife fishing, we have a manatee tours, and most of we, even you, Fisher, even you, do subsistence fishing right here. So don't call it that nonsense, yeah? But me, Peppy.
No, Miss Rose, we wouldn't want to see a fight out there. We're all neighbors.
Now, why always?
Tell her, brother, tell her.
We hate to see a hurt Fisher, dog.
If you let guys see a photo jokes, they still dry.
Hands for
who, Miss Rosa? That me you talk about? Hands for me?
Yes! You want this and you ain't got it. What kind of nonsense is this? Ah, the fish are dead on my house because somebody wanna got no sense that don't send me from there.
Miss Rosa, who you know that fish are truly want me to see?
You never call me on name, whatever, still know what I mean.
Shut up, man, Fisher. Miss Rosa, you say when the person will throw the cement in the sea? You never see nobody, so you can't come out here and point fingers. As a matter of fact, none of we are afraid for you.
Thank you, heaven.
Except for Fisher.
You know who? I don't afraid of nobody. I don't want that woman. So can I see a woman?
So Fisher.
What is? Come on, man. You have to put this thing to a pass. How are we expecting? You're not back on the road.
This is a problem with you, no. Me, I'm just one man with one dream. A dream of expansion, of progress. But all I do, I just circle around my dreams like some damn cattle. They try to pick it apart. All I do good for, I mumble and complain. 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 Sick and tired of people in this village. You can't even try plan. You can't even try expand. You can't even try progress the place. Cause everybody just want mumble and complain. We all know all this will not stop. You don't even think about how it's going to impact your community.
That we are wrong, Roach. All this done to the horse, I mean we, want a lot of money. And besides, when the last time you sell anything for your shop? When the last time? And you, Sonny, when last you give up any tourist for a tour? Exactly! We need your action around your man!
Yes, Fisher! Action away all the way again, because me not just gonna get one more minute to make that piranha over there continue on growing. But you know what? Some things just don't work, man!
Like you, now my mom will let you.
No, no, no! She wouldn't go right to the emergency room.
Miss Rose, we are all neighbors out here. I expect you to be back and go be if we can't work together.
Yeah, man, we can't destroy the village, man, if we pick you, right?
Yes.
Well, this is why I say all this while, but that, like, you don't know me, listen. You know, my late husband used to have a way of putting things with the sea and life. He used to say they got two types of man. The ones that were doing limited destruction, he used to call them one low tide. And the ones that were do fatal damage and greedy, like some people, he used to call them one high tide.
Wait, Miss Ross. What do you mean by late? Late as your husband not come on yet? Or late as he dead? Because last time I checked my ride down to Hopkins with the new family for the beach side, the city broke or not?
What you didn't try say? I got somebody who has stretched the truth.
I want to say a liar, you're a liar, doctor!
Why all this talking? But you could just string up what is a sink out of sea. You adults just love to talk. And some names I won't call just can't face the truth. So they lie at bad. You get child anyway. Otis was sink this place. And make it worse enough. Land not available. The erosion to shrink the place, people. Soon a lot of adults want quarry for rooftop.
I have an idea where we solve all of our problems and a solution to where we save mangrove bay.
I just want to mention that some of us have bigger problems. Right, Mr. Ross? I mean, nothing that bring back Mario. Can you care cook to save your life? You can't.
This is important, man. My suggestion? You remember what? Bony fish aquarium.
What?
Wait.
What?
For what?
A bony fish aquarium!
And we are putting it.
We are putting both this! Ali, you're finally the show sign of crazy!
You may need to got some respect, right?
Now, but I mentioned that again, kind of make more sense. That now work the mangrove bay, I guess I put you and your family in there for sure.
Yes, Ali, you must be there for medication, because we not going to get creatures dead on it. They're not protected by law.
The you are now, Miss Ross?
They're like, Ali, we're not crazy like what this. Desperate and stupid too! They were in the age of the Juno, so this is craziness.
Hold on, wait a minute, I'll try listen to the man. You're not gonna have a problem with my idea. Come on, man, listen to the man.
Finally, somebody simple like me.
Yeah.
Why y'all forget back to autogram it? You gotta get our prime minister.
All right.
Alright, go, Sonny. Let it low, let it rank so.
No, Miss Fatima.
Let me make a hack. So, Sonny, you don't want to talk to you.
What is it? Alright, alright, man.
Mommy.
So,
Mama B.
The stars are
red. We are the stars.
Remember, till you're in that hole.
call her Sister Violet?
Oh, yes!
Remember they say Violet, Ghana presents a big upon mission. It can do the Lord's work.
Yes.
Violet never gone nowhere.
What?
After Mama B dead, Theolinda,
me,
and his sister Violet come up with a whole story
to
try to trick the community. I know what they do.
What?
They dress up Violet as Mama B. This time, Violet!
Look, people attack, and we are like that, and as you are one,
wife? Am I supposed to hear? I don't like when young people listen.
What? Understand this. Progress come at a cost. I don't care what nobody say. You feel support me. You feel there beside me.
Well, care what I say. My baby take her first step right there on that beach and I look at it. It's disgusting. I go smash.
Shut up, man.
What? You want to listen to me or you listen to me good?
That's right.
And I see me that I've been in the water. Think it dead. It look nasty what it.
But you know what I complain when I buy all the jewelry of that time? You know what I complain when I put food? Now all of a sudden, you want to come and listen to everybody say they come complain and mumble? Woman, know your place.
Ooh. I know my place and my place are right side of you. You're equal.
Well, it might not be that way for long if you are continuing this way.
Really?
You might just fuck up your bag and left.
Well, me, I pack up my bag and my baby and we go in and you know, I see me again.
I don't care about that. Me? I try to expand. I try to make things better. Not only for me, not only for you, but for everybody. And if you can't understand that, then best you rule.
Look, your so-called vision, because everybody's something, not just me, not just you, and not just Sonny Shop and Ali Shop.
But just shut up. It took early in the morning to go through this.
I knew you'd talk to.
I didn't talk to you, but I sick and tired of everybody just to try to tell me what to do. The last time I checked, I don't big man.
Big man, come on, come on, come on.
You know what? Enough of this. Just go inside and do what you got to do. Like I said, I don't make anybody from this community come and tell me what to live my life or what I need to do. I make my own decisions. And if you want to stay with me, then you could do that. But if you have a problem, like I said, you could roll. Sick and tell everybody come and tell me what to do.
Look, man, I really hope you listen to me because that's stupid. That's what it.
It's a problem, you know.
Anthony,
come on
now. I'm gonna tell you, Fisher.
Fisher, the way I want.
Anthony, I just started to talk to a white man for a boat, and he looked rich. I mean, he got money, but that's smart. She said, "Well, you got
it." You can't go, Fisher. As a matter of fact. Shut up, Fisher. It's too early for this.
Epic.
Fisher, shut up.
Epic.
Fisher.
Epic.
I just one man, you know. One man with a dream. I think about expansion. Like I said, we need better than Mangrove Bay. But all the people good for, have to mumble and complain. They don't got vision like me. They don't understand how to develop the place. They don't understand progress. Sick and tired of it.
Good morning, Otis.
My name is Mr. Rogers.
How are you? Well, girl, let's up. I think I said no to the offer.
What about Fisher anyways?
I know about Fisher. May I tell you, I had something earlier. But why you are saying no to my offer, Mr. Rogers? Not like you have any plans. Me. I had a conflict, hand mangrove bay. Expand all. Mr. Rogers, my plan, you see how many boats out there? I plan to bring plenty times more boats. More huts, bigger and better huts, so more people can come on mangrove bay. More people, you know what I mean? More merchandise to sell. More merchandise to sell, you know what I mean? More money. More money for Otis, more money for you. More is everybody in a mangrove bay.
But please, you think making more rooms or bringing more people? The people tired of having hours just to say one bone fish or this. You think the people that want to come and just a room 4 hours that they're in jail?
So, what are your plans? Since that don't make sense, what are your plans, Mr. Rogers?
Well, since me and Sonny been talking, what we are doing for weekends? We'll capture a couple of the few little pretty fishes there. You know the bone fishes? Right out of the water, right here. And we're putting our aquarium on.
What?
So that people have a purpose or a reason to come. Not to say 4 hours.
Seriously, Mr. Rochester? That your big plan? That the man I ever hear. Nobody come from England, from Ireland, from Japan, from South Africa to see fish in an aquarium. What do you think about America for them? The people, they want to come here and they want to be able to go up on the sea. They want to be able to see the fish and the turtle in their natural habitat. They want to be able to get in our boat early in the morning and go up on the sea and see the sunrise and see the birds that fly. Your plan don't make no sense. Like I said, it's stupid. Everybody in this community think fish are dumb.
Why not?
You set a new record, my brother.
See birds fly and the fish is name. But snapper like what I eat every day. But I don't worry about what you say.
Your wife even know you to do? Wife? You don't worry about my wife? Should I be the least of your concern, Mr. Roaches? And the last time I checked, your wife red left Mangrove Bay. So if I like you, I'd have pop up behind she and follow and go back to PG. Because you might just left here without a woman. Think about that.
Well, I never even have an argument just now.
Curly face.
No, no, no. This don't make no sense. How my pop and Mr. Roaches could think any of their ideas over Bessie, we are the animals. I know we need to make money so things could run smoothly, but how they could think endangering these beautiful aquatic animals away, right? This don't make no sense. It just don't make no sense. You know what? I'll have a good talk with my pop. He could come up with a better solution to this, because this don't make no sense. Dad, I could please talk to you, please?
Right now, honey, I got a bad money. Your mom, Mr. Roaches, everybody will try to get on the nerves. Just give me a moment. So, the way I want to talk, where do you go?
Well, Dad, I still don't know how a lady went here for asking me to the villagers, because she kind of concerned you to do your own thing.
I never know nothing about this. Who are you talking about?
Dad, I say, I think nature should be treated with care the same way how we treat your boat engine.
Boat engine? I'm into the boat business game. Who are you talking
about? Now, like, you don't think I need something on my own, Dad. Something for my future, the ocean can't take care of itself.
Shirley, I am a developer. I don't know no babysitter. The ocean don't need nobody pity. Where does it come from?
Well, after that, I cannot overhear.
What?
Watching.
No, Shirley. How many times I have to tell you? You not to listen to grown people conversation.
I know that.
Nothing. You don't want to listen to my conversation and then try to use it against me. Unacceptable!
But Dad!
But nothing, Shelley! Understand, the waters run deeper than what you know. Life, bigger than what you know. You too young to even understand how big life really is. You see this? This is nothing in comparison to what it could really be. Nothing will happen in Mangrove Bay. No expansion, no progress. I plan to do that. I plan to make it bigger and better to everybody. How many people do that give me a piece of land and they are sick? They will see the progress that I could bring to Mangrove Bay.
No, Dad. No. You need to stop and you need to listen to me. Okay? I have a future. This community have a future. You need to stop where you go. You know what my teacher tell me? She tell me that the coastal planning very essential between human and nature, that you can't do this. You can't dirty up the place and expect things to get better. You need to stop being selfish and listen to what everybody else has to say.
First of all, tell the sense teacher, stick to science. Me, I love developer, and I know where to go. All of that, just some like lazy man business. Your sense teacher don't got no place in this. Me, like I said, we need to bring progress. Progress for everybody. So stop with this nonsense.
You just don't like listen.
Shut it! Stop the back chat, okay?
Okay.
Damn, if they lose their place. First woman, then neighbor, then pick me. No one wrong with them. Shelly, are you there? What are you crying for?
I don't cry.
Wait, I walk after I come. Shelly, what happened to you?
I think you understand.
You can talk to me, and I'm a good listener.
Well, I know what, in that case, could tell me what that reason behind this money business.
Money?
Yeah, like, why people finally collect so much money?
You see, Shelly, this different, this is because of greed.
Greed like power?
No, man, this different is still because when people have money, they think that that's more important than everything else in their life. Because when they think they have so much money, they think that they could have a lack of power and benefits.
Well, wait. How you know all of this?
Well, you see, when I'm 10, my mom and my family didn't have a terrible car accident, and I had to get a job and fend for myself. But while working at this place, I get to meet a lot of good people. And my boss, him a good man too, and he kept the business going as long as he could. But one day, one greedy man, he walked in at the spot and buy over the whole store. He just ended up packing it up because the place was small. So I and my young cultural drummer without a job, and that's why I moved to my movie.
Well, I'm sorry for your loss, but why you had to lose away your life?
This man, he had big plans for the store. So you just pop up our rule.
So, what are the best solution for this greed then?
To be honest, then I have more than one answer for greed, you know. Because greed makes people lose sight of what valuable in life. And because of greed, nature gets destroyed.
Well, you know what? I think we need to come up with a solution to protect our natural resources.
Resources? What do you mean, like land?
Yeah.
Shelly, you know a land for sports fishing? Is that sometimes you have to keep the fight sharp or not to sharp? Put it like this. Sometimes in our life, we just need to know how to approach things.
Sports fishing?
Yeah.
That's so complicated. Ooh, I get it. You mean I have to talk to my dad? Well, I need to approach it. I need to understand the key situation. The light. All of we could exist in our nature, but we just need to respect it.
Yeah.
My path, me to respect it. You know what? I'm going to go talk to him so he can go with a better solution to this. Thank you, Dave. Thank you.
Yeah, well, it's almost time for supper, so I guess we should head back to the village.
Let's come on.
Well, As I was saying, I'm in town for business and I'm looking to buy something.
Sure. Sorry!
Poor. So why all of you not sell and done, Sonny?
Oh,
So you want to sell now? And you're that stupid is when Otis asks you for buy? What change now, Albert?
Well, for one, the buyer on me Otis Barclay.
So yeah, we really are sell for Wheeler.
My wife said, you have all peeled me. I'll be happy that you bring Marinia. I'm trying to place you now.
Yes, but well, I don't expect the man to buy the clothes out of over. This all happened so sudden. Besides, I'm a plan for this to my family.
Which family?
I plan to have some here.
You know where this is coming from, Sonny? Sonny, if all person and none of them, smell scam, Albert, you better think this true. Because if only not sell, Otis will never sell any man say, all the land earn none at all.
Who care what Otis said? I don't care what Otis said. I sell my land and all the rich out of this name. If Otis been in front of me, Fisher, right now, I'm gonna tell him that I, less than personal memory on the turn, twice moved my father's side, that I quit.
What you mean, sir? Tell me, I never quite hear you, but you hear me.
I said, if Otis been in front of me right now, I, now tell him that I.
You got words for me, Fisher? You got something to tell me?
You have to. I was going to tell Alia this deal was going to get. Tell her.
Go on. You're a damn coward. Tell the man again. So, and this is the kind of spanish weasel you want to do this, man. Come on.
Fisher, what kind of deal you blab about?
What is? My man walking a man go up here with a lot of money. I say, what about the place? What if you go with $50,000 US each?
What? You no serious? But babe's going to pay quick. Hurry, babe, come, you need to hear this. Yeah, man, hurry up.
Now what?
Repeat what I said just now, Sonny. Make me wife here away with me to tell me.
Well, Miss Pat, earlier today, my man called for my girl, babe, saying, what about the place? We need to get each away $50,000 US each. And your man got real money. Oh, thank you, pesos like your husband. US dollars.
Really? Seriously? So a man come out of nowhere, want buy all our own land.
What man don't even know?
But when my husband, somebody who don't know, I want to buy all the land, like he got some kind of evil, like he got the devil.
No, this one. We got a chance to make real money. What kind of real money? $50,000, F.A. Now give you $50,000, you $50,000, you $50,000, everybody, F.A.
Well, you're not giving me $50,000. Because me, for once, not a sell, and I can't believe we're going to do this. I'm not a sell. I don't know that sense, right? The good lad did with sense.
Apparently not.
Well, this is your chance. I'm going to speak for yourself. And we all know the good lad is my blessed fish.
Not that true.
But seriously though, come on. We really have to think this out. We really ourselves, we like. We really ourselves.
What is it? Otis!
What more, Rosa?
Oh, you got too far, Otis!
What are you talking about?
Well, big boat out there muddying up the water, and you they are like, you not care. After all the selfish things you do, really, Otis, now this? Look, Rosa, me don't know where tree you drop off at this morning, but that's not my husband, boat.
My wife, that.
Who else?
Miss Rose, calm down. Actually, that was yeah. One man called earlier today said, what about mangrove beer? Now this man have a lot of money, you know, 50 pesos time. Well, this is you know, real American US dollars. And man will be paying $50,000 each, US.
Yes, Miss Rose. And the buyer, he want to take me to better, higher heights.
I still don't understand. You know, just not make no sense.
May I explain it to you, Miss Ross? They are hypocrite. They give an offer for a man.
I know all of them willing to sell after all they put me through. But all I want to know, any of you know, they ask that man what plans he have for Mangrove Bay? You know, ask?
No, you shush, what is shush? What offer? How much?
$50,000.
It's yours. The man really serious about this thing, and it's yours. But we all know how you feel about it. You are Mario.
Mario? You not bring Mario in at this? He gonna let me figure mine out of who's gonna take me, and you the yelling? That was Mario. We don't care about Mario. Come on, where are we saying, baby? Where are we saying?
Watch it. Right,
really, Rosa? Alright, guess how you walk around head held high that you are Mother Nature, Rosa? Seriously?
Mm-hmm.
So fake, I can't even believe
you.
You're
not one fake, Patty.
Not talk to my
own. Believe it. Believe it. Now we move up. And we move out. Yeah?
Oh, yes.
I can't understand something. Me, what is not the same. Me, like, if the man could come here and give you $50,000, give you $50,000, which I don't even know where you are doing $50,000. But if he could come here and give everybody $50,000, you know they can't develop this place. That destroy here, destroy it. All the bonefish, they are dead. All the turtle, they are dead. Everything going down the drain.
Even you.
Me, not a cell. Not over my dead body. And so how that different from the ones you not basically like somebody being able to do the one.
Tell the man.
Oh, you see? You know, like, listen. Like I tell you many times before, I did come to develop this place, not destroy it. All we need to do is just give me the owner land, and everybody may have benefit. But no. You know, like, listen.
I don't want to talk about this big $50,000. Uh-huh. But where are they for with me?
But then, what for all that guy? Shelly! Shelly, come here, baby, come here. Shelly, hurry, man.
Yes, Dad?
Data. Tell them people where they tell me the other day about the natural resources.
What that? I don't understand. Where you tell me? So, man, who are buy this place? And these adults think it's a good idea to sell him heritage. And they say, pick me, no, no, nothing.
And who will talk to you, Candy?
Shush. So wait. Ali,
hold on. I just catch up to the top of my damn stuff.
Go wait. So, honor they tell me that I don't want to sell up to honor life. And I know all the man can read it. I don't wish I'd be ashamed of the
Shelly,
your father goes down.
All the man dead.
Shelly, your pack up down all the man go over here. So anything we sell here, no safe. Sell high and quick. Daddy, you worry. All of the people should have be ashamed of the same.
As long as I get paid, I can live in any amount of shame.
Bye-bye, Sherry.
You see? This is a woman to try to avoid. Never let a mangrove affect, when hurricane affect mangrove, they're so bad.
Wait, we're gonna fix all of this. We're gonna all work together.
Yeah, this one, Yashino. Shelly, look around. We can't even find the bathroom. I can't imagine where the long papers there fly. I had one dream, Shelly, and it was to get out of this dump. And now, I'm stuck.
We could rebuild. It's about we live. It's about we grew up. Mangrove build up we warm. Next time we rebuild, we have to learn from this mistake. And we have to contact coastal zone management.
That's true, and this time, I will help. Nobody needs a call ahead of the other one.
$50,000! God found my fingers just like that.
Really, Fisher? That's the way you're worried about $50,000! Now watch out, women, I got nothing!
You see, Otis, this is what happens when I try to cheat nature. When man ignore the balance that's supposed to exist between the society and the mangroves, then not because you will have to live.
Are my clothes? I lost everything and I don't have more family to run to because Mario still not come back. I just can't start over. How I will start over?
Seriously, Rosa, you think you're the only one that lose? We cut down all of them mangrove and them mangrove to protect we! Now we have to learn from this. My mom got through a similar storm. And they come together and they build back as a community and I know we could do it.
You know what, guys? This is our sign. We could bring back Mangrove Bay. We could do this. We just need to come together as a community. And we have to build back this place, nail by nail, and board by board. One set!
Shut up, Otis!
Ladies and gentlemen, the Tides of Men, thank you so much. Presenting our cast for Tides of Men. Shelley Barkley, Alicia Dawson. Pat Barkley. Brianni Novello. Sonny John Domingo. Candy Merman. Rochelle Bob. Rosa Gonguez. Myrna Rivera. Mr. Roches. Randy Cleland. Mrs. Roches. Lacanian McFasden. The Ute, Nerlan Lowers. Mr. Stephen Marin, Jack Pitsor. Stanley Morgan. Theolinda Jaya McFasden. Mama B, Alicia Lewis. And our neighborhood destroyer, Otis Barkley, Randall Shepherd. And last but not least, Leston Fisher, Merman Raheem Phillips. Our stage manager, Celestina Zook. Want to talk her backstage people, Shanice Zook. want to thank Jaimon, Jaimon Roberts for lights. Want to also thank Carleen, helping backstage as well. We want to call Mrs. Young once again to close off tonight.
Good night once again. Let's give these guys another round of applause. For a fun-filled night. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the director, Joseph Stamp-Romero, as well as all the cast members for working tirelessly for the past couple, I believe, months, working, putting this show together, and to you all for coming out and supporting Coastal Zone and supporting our local artists. Thank
you.
We hope you enjoy the night, took home some key messages, and continue to help us protect our resources for our Belizeans to continue to enjoy. Thank you. Good night.
I want to thank you guys for coming out. It's hard to write for these guys, right? Randall and Raheem, they're phenomenal. Of course, our young rising star, Rochelle Bob. Rochelle is a child of the bliss. So thank you so much to the entire cast. Right. Thank you so much. Thank you guys so much for supporting this production. Raheem reminded me, if I don't thank my wife, I won't be able to sleep inside. I'm up on the beach like Mr. Roches. I want to thank my wife, Delani Romero, for helping us backstage as well.
Ladies and gentlemen, we love the people of the terror. We can't do the lazy body people there. Watch out. Every pussy must work. I don't like that. Work. Every pussy must work. Young or old. Work harder. Every pussy must work. Find our block. Every passing must work. Work hard. Watch this. Cause if you're not working, you gotta be loafing. And if you're not loafing, then daddy, you gotta be joking. You must work. I'm a lie. And don't be a jerk. Every passing must work. Work hard. EY is like lazy body, not gonna work. Man and woman, they better try to do some work. Chicks, they ball out. Sure. But a woman who don't try to do some work told me a talk before the bell.